finding the solution to the problem. Let's talk about that. So I'm going to give you first the situation. We're going to go backwards here. John is a person who's not comfortable about saying no. He always says yes. He's over-exercised in that part of his personality that is accommodating, and that's something that he learned in childhood. But he's got all this work on his desk, and his friends invited him to go see a movie, and John could not access that part of himself to say no. So he goes to sleep, and he dreams that he's climbing up this big, tall ladder, and papers are everywhere, even blocking some of the steps on his way up. And who's at the top of the ladder encouraging him up is his roommate from college that he hasn't seen in about 20 years. But I asked John, tell me very quickly, using a symbols point of entry, what are the first two or three things that come to your mind about that roommate? And John's answer was, well, he was a real selfish, take care of me first kind of guy. Hello. That's who John needs to access, that ability that he has to be able to say, no, this isn't working for me. And because he understood the language of the metaphor and the solution to the dream, the following morning he picked up the phone and called his friends to say, I'm sorry, love you guys, but I'm not going to go see a movie with you tonight. I'm going to focus on my work because there's all these papers on my desk and I want to look after it.